Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you're going to learn how to apply Zoom in PowerPoint 2016 or even an earlier version of PowerPoint so that you're able to highlight a certain portion of a picture. Now, this is in response to a question asked by one of our YouTube subscribers, and the question is this. I'm having a slide with chart, and next to that chart, I have a newspaper clipping on the same slide. I want to zoom a specific article in that newspaper page, which is relevant to the chart on the same slide, so as to make it distinguished from other news contents. How can I do that? Or at least, how can I make the rest of the news page 50% transparent while keeping the part I want normal or clearly visible? In other words, this subscriber has a newspaper clipping to show on the slide. He wants the audience to see only a part of the newspaper clipping clearly, while the rest of the newspaper clipping should be semi-transparent. So that is the question. Since this is a common requirement in most business presentations, I thought I would provide the answer with a video today. Now, take a look at this newspaper clipping. I just picked up some random newspaper clipping from the net purely for demonstration purposes. Let us say you want your audience to see only a part of the clipping, like say this paragraph to be seen clearly, and you want the rest of the paper clipping to go semi-transparent. The way to go about that is like this. First, you draw the viewer's attention to the specific part of the clipping, and then you can see that that part of the clipping is now enlarged so that the audience can clearly read the content, and the rest of the content, as you can see here, is semi-transparent. And all this happens in just one click. Let me show you how it is done, and this can be quite useful in any technical presentation wherever you want to do some kind of a citing of a picture or a newspaper clipping or even a Wikipedia article. First, I start with the picture. I'm going to make a duplicate of this picture. So I'm going to say Ctrl D. Ctrl D is the shortcut for duplicate, as you know. And I'm going to place my duplicate right on top of the original image. The next thing I need to do is to go to Picture Format, go to the Crop tool, and then crop it in such a way that only the portion that you want to highlight is visible. Like you can see here, I am just cropping out everything else, and I'm retaining only the portion that I want like this. Now I am happy with what I have done, and you can see that there is no difference between the area that I chose and the rest of the picture because this is placed right on top of the original picture. The next thing I'm going to do is to draw the viewer's attention to this specific part. So let me go to picture border, and I'm going to use red colored picture border. And I'm going to increase the weight so that it's very clearly visible, maybe 4.5 points, or the width can be chosen by you the way you want. The next thing we need to do is to add some kind of animation so that this part is highlighted. I'm going to keep the animation pane open so you can see what I'm doing here. Now let us choose a simple entrance animation. The one that I'm going to use is wheel animation. You can see that this is the way the animation plays. That is a good enough animation for the audience to take notice of that. And you can see that the default duration of this is 2 seconds, and that is way too long. So I'm going to make this to 0.5 seconds. The next thing I'm going to do is to make this expand. So I'm going to apply another animation to the same object. So to do that, you need to go to the Add Animation option. You cannot use any of these animations now, otherwise the earlier animation would get replaced. So let us go to Add Animation option, and the one that I'm going to use is under Emphasis, and it is called as Grow Shrink Animation. You can see that this is how the animation plays. It's a very beautiful way in which you can make your audience see the content. I'm going to have this happen after previous. The next thing we need to do is to have this one go semi-transparent. So I'm going to select this one, go to Add Animation, or I can go for any of the animations here. And the animation that we are going to choose is this one called as Transparency. Can you see here? This part becomes semi-transparent automatically just on a click. And we are going to have this happen with previous. So to summarize, we have used 3 types of animation here. The first one is to draw the viewer's attention, and the animation is wheel entrance animation. The second one is an emphasis animation called as grow shrink animation, which happens after previous. While this object grows, this bit is going to be semi-transparent because for this we have chosen a transparency type of animation from emphasis option. Now let us go to the slideshow and see how this whole thing works. On a click, you can see that this is how the animation plays. Of course, it is up to you to choose the duration of animation. If you want it quicker, then you reduce the duration. If you want it slower, you increase the duration and so on. Now, what I've shown you is not something that you would find in any book or a course, because this is a creative way of using the common tools that are already available in PowerPoint. In Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery program, you will find a whole bunch of such creative workarounds, techniques, and tricks that will help you to use the tools in PowerPoint in creative ways. If you are a professional and you need to use PowerPoint as part of your profession, then Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery program can be a useful program for you. I will leave a link to this program in the description box below this video. You can click on the link and find more details about this program. Come here, check out the video and see what kind of things are being taught in this program. And if you think it is a useful one, then you can go ahead and join the program. By the way, did you like the zoom technique taught in this video that allows you to showcase a part of a picture? If you did, then please hit the like button and also share this video with your friends. If you want to watch more such videos that give you creative ideas in PowerPoint and Excel, then please hit the subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can be notified about any new video we post on this channel. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.